Hi everyone, welcome to the show. This is Bear Fitness and I'm Laura Williamson, your host. Today's show, we are going to be talking about some fun stuff today, so you definitely want to stay tuned. Today's show is actually going to focus on fit pregnancy. That's right, fit pregnancy. So I have two great guests. My first guest is Francine Wilkins. She'll be in the studio with us today. Francine, say hello.
Hi.
Welcome, Francine. And then we also have Mary Oscategui. She's going to Skype with us today. She's in California. So we're going to talk with her, and Mary's going to give us all advice that's new, old. She's going to help us out with anything and everything that has to do with pregnancy, nutrition, fitness, yoga, stress, you name it. Mary knows everything. Mary's all-knowing. She's the wizard today on fitness and pregnancy. But before we even go there with Mary, we're going to start with a 30-minute workout. I want to give you some exercises that you can do at home to help you along with your pregnancy. But before you start today's routine, I want you to keep in mind that if you haven't been working out before you were pregnant, and if you're not working out currently as you are pregnant, you really shouldn't start any new fitness program, any new routine at all if you're pregnant. If you have never worked out at all, once again, get permission from your doctor before you start this routine or any other. Okay, so I welcome you to stay, join, and follow along with me. And I'm going to try to give you, as I say, modifications as I go. And we're going to do this for about 30 minutes. And then I'm going to talk to Francine. We're going to talk to Mary. And we're going to follow up with them and see if they can give us a little information, a little advice. And also Francine, because she's been through it and she actually worked out after her pregnancy, maybe she can give us a little information as to how her pregnancy went and how she stayed fit and lost her weight afterwards. And also Mary, too. She has a little girl. So we're going to start. Take your time. Go slow. Do not rush it. Even if I'm moving fast, you take your time and you move at your own pace, okay? So have fun with it and be careful, more importantly. So I'm going to start out on this mat right here, and then you follow me as best you can, all right? So here we go. Your hands are going to go in front. We're going to start with a little stretch, first and foremost, and you want to be on all fours, hands down, knees down, feet behind you. As you do this, we're going to do what we call the cat and camel, okay? So from here, you're going to lower your head down, pull your stomach in and up, stretching your spine, and then you're going to stretch, lengthen, lift the chest, press the tailbone to the ceiling, and you're going to go from here, all right? So that's what you want to do. And once again, you're going to curl in, and then you're going to lower down. And then you want to do this 12 times and keep going with it. And this is going to be a nice stretch for you, because actually, as I was trying to say, it will relieve a little bit of tension on your lower back, which is why you want to do something like this. It will help stretch you out, improve your flexibility as you go, because as your weight starts to change, your center of gravity changes because you have more weight in front. And then you might get a little tight because your bottom will stick out more because the weight is more front. And then this will help stretch you out a little more when you go that way. Okay, so keep going. We're going to do three more. It's always nice to stretch before you work out, just a little bit. And two more. One more to go. And rest. Hold the position. Now we're going to change it up a little bit. So we're going to work on something for your balance and for the core muscles. So you're going to lengthen and stretch. So now lift up the right arm and the left leg. Extend. This is a bird dog. So you want to reach forward and bring the hand and leg down and change. And reach. Keep reaching and change. You got to make it fun. Make it interesting. So you want to reach. You want to do 12 of these two. And you want to keep moving. So this is two. We're going to do 12 of these, 12 sets. And I know if you feel like you're moving slow, it's okay. You have time. I have time. We'll do it together. All right? Do the best you can to keep your balance. Engage the muscles. Ask the baby to help you out. Keep going. Reaching and lengthening. And you want to get your lines as straight as possible as you move. Now, if you feel your lower back dipping, so maybe your bum is sticking out, try to pull in and up and engage the abs a little more as you keep reaching and lengthening. Reach away from yourself. Okay? And let's do two more sets. And one more. And there. All right, now from here, we're going to line to the side. So we're doing a little bit of core because core is good. You want to strengthen the core muscles just a little bit to help you out and keep your balance, strengthen the lower back, all of the above. So now let's say you don't work out at all right now. So if you can, you can straighten out the legs. We're going to do a side plank, and you can lift up and lower yourself down. But let's say this is too hard for you, you're not used to doing this. So what you want to do is lift and lower. But again, oh, you can't lift, bend your knees. Try this instead. Lift, cut it in half, and bring it down. And lift it again, and bring it down. Now if your shoulders bother you, don't do this exercise at all. We can do something else altogether different, and we'll change it. But for now, we'll just give you modifications for this, and then we'll work from here. All right, so you definitely want to do 12 of these. 5 more to go. You're doing awesome. Stay with me. Keep it going. Let's do 3 more. And you should feel a little burn on the side like I do right now. Last time. And bring it down. Now, come on up. You got to do the other side. You don't want to be lopsided. So, you definitely have to work both sides. So, keep your knees bent. All right. You and baby can work out. Legs behind you. And lift up. And down. Keep going. Up. And lift. Keep moving. 5, 6. Squeeze your bottom. You want to lift from the hips, but focus on the abs. Let's do 2 more. Make this your last one. And bring it down. And rest. All right. Now we get to do everything all over again. All right. So this is where we're going to go. So now we're going to go back into our quad position. Let's do our cat and camel stretch, everything out just a little bit. So relax your head, shoulders back and down. You want a nice little square here, so pull the ribs in once again, and lift, lower, lift, down, keep moving, and down. 4. This is 5. Up and down. Lift and down. 4 more. Hang in there. You can do it. It's a nice little stretch. This should feel real good to you right now. And even if you're not pregnant, feel free to do this workout, because if you have lower back discomfort, any pain like that, this will help with that too, by the way. Okay, so actually anyone can do this workout. Make this your last one. And down. Pretty much all my workouts, everyone should be able to do my workout. You just have to modify, okay? Now the next one, bird dog. Right arm forward, left arm back. Change. And reach. 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 Keep going. Reach. Very good. I see you. You're doing a good job. So stick with it, okay? Keep it moving. We'll do it together. Keep moving. And if the baby wakes up, just say mommy's working out right now. And you work out together, okay? So keep it moving. And going. And going. Let's do 4 more. 4 more. And 3. 2 more to go. Almost done. Last time. And rest. Good. Ah, good. Now let's do the side plank. So onto that hip. Elbow down. Bent knees. Once again, if you've never done this, this is the best way to start. Hand on the side. And lift. And down. Up. Down. Lift. Down. Keep everything tight. Engage the abs. And lift. Very nice. It's looking good. Feel the burn yet? Lift a little higher. Let's do five more. Four. Three. Two. One more to go. Down. All right, let's change sides. So I'm going to go the opposite angle. Okay, so we're going to go right here. And here we go. Other side. Lift. Lower. Up. Lift. Reach. That's right. Press that hip up. Work the sides. Get rid of the excess. You know, and that way you have strong sides. So when the baby comes, it'll help you out just a little bit, okay? Down and up. Lower. Lower. Three. Two. One more to go. Let's add one more for good luck. And down. Good. All right. All right, so that's our second set. We have one more of each to do. All right, so back on all fours. Make sure you're even first. Hands go directly underneath the shoulders. Line everything up. Now make sure your knees are as wide as you need them to be. If you bring them too close, it might throw you off balance. So make sure you have a nice wide position here. Feet are apart. And then from here, you want to lift it up. Head down, rounding the spine, and slowly dip. Stretch into your position. And in. Lift. Down. And you want to think about breathing, okay? Breathing is important. So you should breathe naturally, but if you find you're having difficulty, try to find long, deep inhales. Fill up the lungs. Exhale. Practice on your breathing. It only helps. Okay? We have a few more to go, so stay with me. You're doing a great job. You know, keep it moving. I'm still moving. You try to do the same. Do the best you can. If you're feeling a little winded right now, it's a bit much for you, take a break, take a moment, have some water, and just start again, okay? But don't overdo it. Do the best you can. Let's do two more. One more to go. And there, relax. All right, now, bird dog. So, same position, find a comfortable stance for you. Make sure you find your balance. You're gonna have to use your stomach here. Lift the right arm, left leg comes up, and reach. Change. Down. Reach. And up. Reach. And down. Reach. And reach. Keep it moving. Keep going. And reach. Keep it moving. We're almost there. Doing awesome. Doing awesome. Two more to go. One more set. Doing awesome. You're rock stars. I know you are. I can tell you're working hard. I could feel it from here. And you're done. Now, onto the side. So roll onto this hip. Elbow down. Knees bent. Lift. Down. Up. Down. Keep it moving. And six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. 11. One more to go. And 12. Done. Keep in mind, please, if anything feels uncomfortable to you, definitely leave it out. Never fight through pain. Pain is never a good sign. All right, muscle fatigue and pain are two totally different things. So be careful and be aware of what your body's trying to tell you. You definitely want to listen, okay? So lift on this side and bring it down. Up and lift. And up, up and lift. Keep it going. Up Up. 10. 9. 8. I know that's extra. I'm aware. 5 more. 4. 3. 2. 1 more to go. And up. And bring it all down. Good. Wow, that was really good. So what I'm going to focus on next, legs, arms, a little bit of upper body. And usually I like to do that because, A, you have to carry the baby. But you don't only have to carry the baby. You need to carry the baby, the bag, and everything else. Okay? So usually you have to multitask, and a lot of these things are very heavy. So I want you to keep that in mind. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with arms first. So if you have weights at home, and they don't have to be heavy, maybe 5 pounds to start. I would recommend at home, if you don't have weights, if you ever decide to buy some, you can go to your local stores, Marshalls, TJ Maxx, Target, Walmart, wherever. Get yourself maybe 5 pound dumbbells, 8 pound, 10 pounds. Those are staples, good to have at home and use them whenever you want to. So for this exercise, all you need to do is stand, feet apart, whatever's comfortable for you. All right, and from here, you're gonna curl and press up. Bring the arms down and straighten. Okay, I'm gonna use 5 pounds today. This is just a moderate weight for you to start with, but if you feel like you wanna do more, you can definitely do more. All right, so we're gonna start it here. Curl, press, down, lengthen. Curl, press, do 12 of these too. So what I did was I combined a couple of the exercises. So if you're low on time, you get more done, all right? So keep curling and pressing. And down. Curl and press. All right, 6 more. Not too bad, right? Keep it going. It's a little fun even if you think about it. Play a little bit of music. You know, keep pushing. All right, let's do 3 more. We're almost there. 2. 1 more to go. Up and down. Good. All right, so the next one, I'm going to give you a little squat. So here's the thing with the squat. If you want to use weight, you can. I'm going to hold on to my weight just for a moment, just to give you an idea. So the hands can go by the side, and actually you're just going to sit in your chair. But guess what? I really don't want you to sit in your chair. This is me sitting in my chair. As comfortable as it is, I don't want this today. What I want you to do is I want you to try to touch your chair and stand back up again. Okay? So you want to sit down and stand. But obviously, if this is too much for you, you don't have to sit all the way down. Just try to touch the seat and come back up, even if you don't touch. All right? So you want to sit and stand, sit and stand. Keep moving. Don't stop moving as I talk to you. Now, if that doesn't work for you, if you're, again, weighted forward, you can always hold on to something, put your hands on the top of something, and do your squats this way, all right? So you can sit down and stand up, and do your squats this way, all right? And just keep squatting. Now, you don't have to just do 12 squats. If you want to, you can do anywhere between 15 and 20, and just keep moving, all right? Now, keep going. Don't stop. I'm going to do the rest of mine. You do the rest of yours. Make sure you got 12 done. All right? I'm going to do 7 more. 1, 2, 3, keep it moving, 4, 5, 6, last one, and 7. That'll keep the bottom nice and tight for you. Put your other weight down. Now, we're going to work on the back, and we're going to work on the triceps, the back of the arms. You know that arm, that little bit that kind of hangs up there when you wave. So let's work on that, and let's work on the back. So from here, you want to stagger your feet, 1 foot in front, 1 foot in back. So the best way to get into this position, if feet are apart, just take a step back. All right? Put one hand down, and what you want to do is pull your weight up and straighten the arm. All right? That's how you want to do that. So again, your feet are staggered, pull up, and extend, and press it down, up, and extend, and down, do 12, If you get a little tired, it's okay. It takes a little getting used to. All right, and keep going. We're halfway there. Only six more to go, okay? Stay with me, you can do it. And five more. And four. Look at you, you're almost through a workout. Hang out with me, don't leave me, stay with me. If you have your water, put your water by your side, take a sip, stop for a moment, start again. Okay? And done. All right, now we gotta do the other side. So change legs. One foot in front, one foot in back. Put your hand back down, and you're going to pull up and press back. Okay, so it's a one-arm row to a kickback. That's what it is. All right, and extend the arm. Nothing too heavy, moderate pace, okay? So keep it moving. All right, we're getting there. Once again, we're halfway there. So six more to go, okay? Start the countdown with me. This is six. And five. Four. Three. Oh, we're almost there. Two more. Last one. And done. All right, so there you go. Two more sets to go. You can do it. So, once again, what we're going to do is we're going to curl and press up. So now we're working the front of the arms, a little bit of shoulder, all right? So curl, press, and bring it back down again. Bend, up, and down. Curl, and reach to the sky, get nice and tall, and reach those arms. Keep it going. Up, and again, lift. And six, we're getting there, I promise you. Seven, eight, nine, 10, two more, one more, look at that. Here we go, we're in the last one, and here we go, and done. All right, squats time. Now remember, your squat is either in the front or it's in the back, you choose, all right? So I'm gonna do my squats in the front, and maybe my last set, I'll do them behind the chair, so you get a full idea of both versions, okay? Now from here, once again, only tap the seat. When I say tap, I mean just feel it slightly and come back up, okay? So tap, sit it down, and come back up, okay? Sit it down, once again, you can use weights or not, it's totally your choice. Trust me, you'll feel it either way. Up and down, up, down, lift, keep it going, and seven, five more, and four, three, two, one more to go, and there, good, excellent everyone. All right, now, we got to do back. We gotta do triceps, we gotta work all that out. Gotta slenderize all that, all right? So from here, behind your chair, or whatever you can put your hand on to stabilize yourself, keep you steady. And from here, you're gonna bend the elbow and straighten and bring it back down again, okay? And here we are, keep it going. Up. Excellent, you're doing a good job. You're almost there, you will have your workout done for the day. Right? Keep going. Six more. It's like magic, you're almost done, right? Halfway through. One more. Three. Two. One more. And done. All right, change sides, change feet. Step forward, put that hand down, and there you go. Ready? And up, out, down. Now, remember now, think about this. If this weight is too light, get higher weight. That's okay. You'll be fine. And no, you won't gain a lot of muscle. I promise. I absolutely promise. I only have 5 pounds right now, But if you want to do 8, it's totally okay. All right? Keep it going. Have fun with it. Just go with it. You know, it's not too bad. Half an hour in your living room. And then you're all done. Okay, 2 more to go. One more time. And down. Awesome. Okay, now, the next thing you're going to do, you're going to do everything all over again. Now, think about this. So there's also a couple other things I'm going to show you, but let's continue with this one, and we'll work from there, okay? So again, squats. I promised you I would go to the back and do my squats from here, all right? So from here, you don't need weight on this one, but if you're far along and again, you know, stability is an issue for you, you definitely want to think about stabilizing yourself by holding on to something. That doesn't mean necessarily leaning. That just means in case you lose a little balance along the way, you have something to catch you if you feel like you're going to tilt over, you can't maintain, you know, your balance for a little bit, your stability. So from here, hands are here, and all you want to do is just sit down and stand up. Now, in this particular instance, when you don't have any weight, if you're feeling up to it, you can do more. You can do about 20 of these. 15, 20, I think it's a reasonable amount if you want to, you know. So why don't we do 15 right now, okay? And we'll start the count right now. Okay, 1, 2, and 3, keep your hands right here, 4, 5, keep moving, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, you only have 3 more to go, 2, and 1. Done. All right. Nice. Okay. One more. 2 more exercises. 1 more of each. All right. Moment of truth. We're almost done, okay? All right. Here we go. Curl, press, down. Curl, press, down. Curl, press, down. I just realized something. So a lot of people will throw their weight to do a bicep curl. You know what I mean by throw? Throw your weight. No. Try to keep your feet still. Keep your body still. Only move the arms. Try to isolate the movement. Do the best you can. Try not to rock if you can help it, okay? It's better that way. You might move a bit, but that's okay. But we don't just want a full-out rock. All right? Let's start from 1. 1. Down. 2. Down. 3. Keep going. I'll let you know where you are. 7. Good. Almost there. 8. 9. 10. 11. Last one. And up. And down. Good. All right. Time for back and triceps. Behind your chair, or find your shelf, hand down, stagger your feet, opposite arm, opposite leg. This is where you want to go. All right, now bring the elbow up and straighten the arm out. And down. And keep going. Just push right through it. If you're tired, keep it moving. Six, 7, 8, all right, count with me, just count through it, I'm not going to tell you where it is, I'm just going to stop, because you know you're almost done, and I know I'm almost done, and maybe one more for good luck, and down, and that's it, let's change hands, all right, ready, this is it, coming around the corner. Oh, missed one. Keep it going. Almost done. Don't cheat yourself. You missed one. Keep it moving. Keep it moving. 6 more. That's it. Almost there. 3, Countdown with me. Two. Last time. One. Ah, and done. There it is. You did the entire workout, okay? So, kudos to you. Stay with us. Don't go anywhere because we have to talk to our guests. They're going to help us out even more. So now you got a workout. Now you get to talk about stress. You get to talk about food. You get to talk about nutrition. So we're going to be right here. You'll come back to see me in about 2 minutes, and then you can meet our guests. And if you have any questions, hopefully we can answer as many questions as we can for you today, okay? So thank you for working out with me, and I'm going to see you soon, all right? Bye. I'll be right here, right in this spot. Well, I might move a little bit when you get back, okay?
If you're not in control, who is?
We about to go get twisted. Y'all coming or what?
Nah, man, I gotta hit the books, man.
Alright,
well. Alright.
Make it happen.
All right, man.
See you guys.
Can I get a check?
Nah. We straight.
Thanks, man.
Hi there, welcome back. This is Vera Fitness. I'm your host, Laura Williamson. And today's show, we are talking about fit pregnancy. We have two guests, Francine Wilkins, who's here with me. Hello, Francine. Thank you for, again, joining us. And we also have Mary Oscategui, who is in California. We're going to Skype with her today, and she's going to be talking to us. She is a baby planner, and she will tell us exactly what a baby planner does and how a baby planner could potentially help you. Okay, so Mary, hi. How you doing?
I'm good, Laura. How are you?
I'm well. Thank you. Thank you for joining me today.
It's my pleasure.
And so, Mary, a baby planner. What is that? Tell us about it, because I'm familiar because you gave me tidbits, but I think the viewers out there would like to have a little more information. So please share with us.
Sure. Well, a baby planner is a maternity consultant that informs, educates, supports, and provides resources to expecting new families. Mm-hmm. So whatever areas they feel in the dark with, or they're stressed about, or they need help with, whether it's choosing the right practitioner, mm-hmm. from a sleep consultant to an exercise professional or even a doctor, mm-hmm. to choosing the right product for their pregnancy or helping them put together a baby shower or nursery, a baby planner is really there to just be the support system, mm-hmm. And help them navigate through all the different areas and themes throughout their pregnancy. And it's very customized, so similar to personal training, mm-hmm. The same way a personal trainer would get together with someone, figure out what their fitness goals are, create a plan. We do the same thing for expecting a new parents, where we just get together with them. We ask them a series of questions, and based on their answers and what their current needs are, then we put together a customized plan that is going to support them throughout and after their pregnancy.
Okay. So is this your company? Was this your brainchild, your other baby, so to speak? Did you start this company?
Yeah. So what happened was, prior to this, I was in the health and fitness industry for 15 years. And when I was pregnant, I lacked support. And although I had all this great background and education and knowledge, I mm-hmm. actually didn't have any immediate family living next to me. Mm-hmm. And so I realized the importance of having a support system and knowing what my resources were, because I was far away from home. Mm-hmm. And I was talking to a friend of mine from New York, and told her about this idea for this company I wanted to start. And she said, "Oh, you sound like a wedding planner," because I said I wanted to help plan for babies. Yeah. And then I then said, "Oh, the baby planner, oh my gosh." And so that's how I started my company. Okay. But a whole new industry began. There's, like, right now there's probably about I'd say about 200 or so baby planners across the world.
Excellent.
And I also started an institution to train those women or even men who want to get started in this career mm-hmm. to open up their businesses. And I've been working with people around the world doing that as well.
Mm-hmm. So where would one find a baby planner? Like, do I open up the Yellow Pages and look up baby planner? Are you, would I find you in a hospital? Would I find you... How do I search you out? Where do I find you?
The best thing to do is just you can go right on Google mm-hmm. and put in your location, let's say New York City baby mm-hmm. planner or mm-hmm. San Francisco baby planner, and you will see business names pop up.
Okay.
And people pop up under that.
Oh.
And because of my health and fitness background, a lot of the additional services that I offer along with that are, of course, exercise and nutrition, because that's just a really big realm of pregnancy, and a lot of women are always in the dark about what kinds of exercises they need to do and or what not to do and how they should get started and all that good stuff.
Oh, well, that's excellent, Mary. I'm sure there are a lot of people out there who wish they had support or have questions or had questions and wish that they had someone they could just ask or get advice or someone who knew where to go to get the answers for them and could bring everything back to them. But tell me, now you have a daughter, yes?
Yes.
And this is, her name is Bella?
Yes, Bella Luna.
Bella Luna, okay. So tell us about your pregnancy, what you went through, because our guest in the studio, Francine, she actually trained with me after her pregnancy. So she can attest to what she went through after having her baby. But what was your experience? Tell us about your experience first, and then I want to go to Francine.
Sure, okay. Well, my experience was quite, it was huge. I decided to have a home birth with my daughter.
Mm-hmm.
So I just made that choice. I wanted mm-hmm. to experience it. I was in Ojai, California at the time, found a midwife who had been working as a midwife for 30 years.
Wow.
And I said, okay, I can put my hands and my trust in this woman mm-hmm. because she's worked with, you know, hundreds and hundreds of women at home and I could work with her,
uh-huh.
and I felt very comfortable. And of course, we took precautions so that I had a backup physician, OBGYN, in the case that, you know, I had to literally go through the proper protocol to ensure that I was healthy and safe
uh-huh.
In order to even have a home birth. And then after that, I had a backup physician to make sure that if indeed anything did go wrong, that I was prepared to go to the hospital. And here's Bella now, just uh-huh. joining us.
Hi, Bella. Hi.
Hey, can you say hi? All right, let mommy talk. No? Okay.
And so after that, I prepared. I, you know, did my Kegels, did my exercises, de-stressed quite a bit. Had a great support system. My labor was actually 18 hours long, and
wow.
she was born 9 pounds.
9 pounds, 18 hours
nine
long.
Pounds. Okay. Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
And my midwife said that my placenta was the biggest one she'd seen.
I'm sure there are a few women who could maybe attest to that too, but that's a different show.
But the experience was really great, very powerful. I can completely understand why women say, okay, enough of the pain, please give me the med. It is quite a physical... you know, as you know, I have tattoos. I have a couple of tattoos.
Yes.
And that doesn't even compare to
okay.
the, well, yeah, every woman's different. Every
yes.
woman's different.
Yes.
For me, it was quite the journey.
Uh-huh.
And I've never experienced anything like that in my lifetime. And, but it's very empowering and very moving. And it's like, it's an experience you just never forget.
Wow. Well, here's the thing. I want to actually, Francine, I'm going to ask you, since we're talking about pregnancy right now and birth. So, Francine, you actually worked out with me after having your son. And tell us your son's name.
Sebastian.
Sebastian. Now, how old is Sebastian?
He will be 4 at the end of this month.
He'll
actually.
Be 4?
Yes.
Uh-huh. And how was your pregnancy? How was the end of your pregnancy? And then how was it for you to work out and get back into being you, who you Well, I won't say who you were before the pregnancy, but how difficult, hard was it for you to get back to being you after having the baby?
Well, I had worked out prior to having my baby. I used
mm-hmm.
to work out about 3 or 4 times a week at the gym.
Mm-hmm.
And during my pregnancy, I would do moderate light walking,
mm-hmm.
mostly.
Mm-hmm.
And then after I had my son,
mm-hmm.
and my doctor gave me the okay,
mm-hmm.
I started training with you, mm-hmm. light at first, mm-hmm. and it got really intense.
It ramped up a little bit.
And yes, it did. But it was very helpful. Mm-hmm. And within, by April, so that was about 4 months, mm-hmm. I felt my old self again, mm-hmm. you know.
So let me ask Mary for a second here. So Mary, can I ask you another question, if you will? So how likely is it that after giving birth that a woman is able to get back to her normal size after giving birth?
Yes. It's very, very likely if she's very committed to her program. And again, if she has prepared prior to the pregnancy with exercise, she will be able to jump back a lot quicker mm-hmm. than if she didn't do any preparation prior. Also, breastfeeding does burn a number of calories. And so what a lot of women, this is one of the secrets of Hollywood. I remember they posted an article, I don't know, it was like
Hollywood secrets right here, everyone. She's in California, so she knows.
Yeah. But breastfeeding's a big one because depending mm-hmm. on the size of your baby and your milk production, you can burn anywhere from 500 to 800 calories. And so a lot of women usually, especially if they're transitioning back to work, give up breastfeeding rather quickly. But a lot of women continue with it on, not only for the benefits of bonding for the baby, but for weight loss.
Hmm. Okay. So, Mary, what I'm going to do is we're going to do this. We're going to take a little break, and you're giving us some really good information that I think is going to help a lot of people, and so Francine is too. So, again, stay with us. We're going to take a little time here, and then I want you to come back and meet us.
Hey, Lemon, you want some smoke?
Nah, man, I'm good.
Hey, I'm not trying to hurt you. I'm trying to help you. I'm trying to get you high. What do you say?
Nah, man, I don't smoke weed. I smoke clowns like you on a b-ball court.
You gotta work on something else for you to say, dude.
And I know it was the first thing I could think of.
But you did good, though, little brother.
Big brothers who live above the influence.
Right.
Have little brothers who live above the influence.
Welcome back, and we're still with Mary and Francine. Mary, thank you so much for taking time with us today. I really appreciate you taking the time. Do you have any last words of wisdom for our mothers out there, mothers-to-be? What would you leave them for advice? What would you leave them with today?
You know, I would say just listen to your body. Mm-hmm. Don't underestimate the intelligence of your body. It's the best thing that you have. And don't ever feel like you have to force yourself or rush anything. The number one killer, if you will, or damage that can happen to any pregnant woman or new mom is stress. Mm-hmm. So just, you know, mm-hmm. Keep the stress on the low and then take it from there. That's my best advice.
Okay. Well, once again, thank you so much, Mary. It was good having you. So we'll talk to you hopefully again in the near future. But now that Mary's gone, we're going to finish up with Francine, and she's going to tell us a little more about her pregnancy. So, Francine, I know you lost a good amount of weight in a very short period of time, but I know you worked hard. I know because I actually trained you.
Yeah.
So tell me, I think they would like to know, how much weight did you lose?
I gained quite a bit of weight.
Okay.
I lost 40 pounds.
You lost 40 pounds?
Yes.
Okay, so you said you had a dress. You were telling me the little stories, like you had a dress and you were wearing that dress. Is it a new dress that you bought, or is it a dress you had? You
it
were
was.
Fitting before you were pregnant.
No, I bought it for my son's, his christening.
Okay.
And that's how I remember, because I had it in April.
Mm-hmm.
So So, like Mariette's mentioned, along with the exercise, I also did breastfeeding, which mm-hmm. helped tremendously.
Mm-hmm.
And the exercise, and once I got the okay from my doctor,
mm-hmm.
I started slow with you, and then I went full force.
Now, you said you walked quite a bit. How? Give us a normal week. How often were you walking? Where were you walking? Tell us about the walking aspect, because what I think a lot of people don't realize, too, is maybe they don't work out a lot. But walking actually is an activity, too. You can walk out. You can walk even if you don't work out. So, you walk anyway. So that's not a bad activity to have.
And it's light.
It is light. So what was your routine or your regimen at the time when you were pregnant?
I would go to the gym sometimes, or when it was warm, mm-hmm. I would do outside walking mm-hmm. a lot.
Mm-hmm.
But I did a lot also on the treadmill. I would alternate
mm-hmm.
because it would get kind of monotonous on the treadmill, so I'd like to go out to the park,
mm-hmm.
Do walking. There's Franklin Park. I went there a few times
mm-hmm.
Right here in the city, and it was great, just mm-hmm. the fresh air and everything.
Mm-hmm. Now, at any point, I'm going to talk to you about abs, because I find the question about abs comes up all the time with women that I train. Now it's an ongoing question. So talk to me about abs. Now, what was your routine for abs? I know I gave you abs. I'm good for giving abs. I'm all about the abs. But tell me, how did you feel about your workouts for your stomach? And what specifically, aside from what I gave to you, were there any things that you did for yourself after pregnancy that I gave to you, or were there other exercises that you did?
I would meet with you about once or twice a week, mm-hmm. and throughout those other 5 days, I would do my own,
mm-hmm.
according to what you gave me. And I remember specifically the ball exercises, because that's
right.
where I felt I yes. made the most strides.
The almighty stability ball.
Oh, the stability
yes,
ball.
Yes, the stability ball.
My friend and enemy.
yes, that you developed a bond at that point. Yeah.
Yes.
So I know I have a tendency to give a lot of core exercises.
Yes.
I demonstrated some side planks previously
mm-hmm.
and so on and so forth. But you know, one thing I should mention to some of the moms out there with regards to Kegels, that's another thing that we haven't touched on, which is very important. And I most recently have read a couple of reports, and they conflict a little bit from my previous beliefs, but again, this is a choice you can make on your own. I know that a lot of doctors mention that you should do Kegels, and you know, you should work those muscles to help for childbearing and birth and so on and so forth. So I think if you go online and you look up the information, I think there are a lot of questions out there that a lot of women have. And I think if you work out, I think walking is fine. I think a regular routine is fine. I think it's definitely something that you should keep in mind and routinely keep in your life before, during, and after your pregnancy. And also eat well. So if anything, going forward, I want to keep in mind with you, the viewer, pregnant or not, if you're thinking about getting pregnant, if you want nutrition advice, you want a better way of doing your workouts, you want ideas, maybe you're bored, you want to do something different, new, here, all the workouts I give to you, everyone should be able to do your workouts, but once again, you must have a doctor's permission and consent. And we're going to be right here, and you stay tuned with us. We'll see you again. We're going to have another interesting show. We might actually talk about cooking at some point, and so on and so forth, and a little bit of fitness and fashion, believe it or not. So we'll see you soon, Francine. Thank you for joining me today.
Thank you for
having
me.
It was a pleasure having you, and hopefully we can have you again real soon.
And
it was also a pleasure having you with me, too. So we'll see you soon. Take care. Be well, and good night.